Well, thank you, Rob. And ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, the fact that we're all gathered here from the spectrum of Australian society reflects the importance of migration to our country. To touch our future is to touch our values, and to contemplate our future is to remember our past, and tonight is such a night. From the outset, migration has been a national endeavour, and so it should be. Migration is far more than economics. It's the core ingredient of nation building. It's not a program of numbers, but one of people, of pioneering and courageous families who put everything on the line and for a punt for a better life. And if we talk about punts, we've got Tony Demetrio here tonight with two of his sons, and they took a punt, and that certainly did pay off. I've lived through the post-war immigration period. I've seen up close their struggles and the enormous cultural and economic contribution that they have made to building the nation. And of course, my start in the private sector was through one of our great migrant nation builders, Franco Belgiorno Nettis, my great friend and mentor who every day I miss. Migration has been a collective endeavour. In the early post-war days, representatives from business, the unions and the newly formed Immigration Department considered who should come and how to help and encourage them. They toured the source countries, debated what skills we needed, and crafted our early support policies. From the start, immigration was seen as a shared imperative and a collaborative effort. It was bipartisan. It's self-evident that a policy which determines our very composition and defines who we are must be owned by all of us. Migration is essential to continue to drive prosperity in Australia. Business is a part of our community. We are the community, and we are committed to working for the growth and prosperity of all Australians. Business is increasingly judged on the social and economic values we spread through our activities. Business is the driver of prosperity in our nation, but we must have a strong and equitable society to deliver. We must have a society which fosters participation and provides the opportunity for all to contribute. As supporters of a strong immigration program, business has an important role in providing job opportunities for them. A marked characteristic of our immigrants is that they want to contribute and want nothing more than a chance to work and to provide education and security for their families. It's our collective responsibility, government, business, unions, and the wider community, to ensure that we eliminate the barriers to employment and welcome and encourage those who are finding their feet. We must recognise their challenges. Many of you tonight have experienced them. Just imagine starting afresh, not understanding the language or culture in a world with different systems and customs. Just getting to the first job interview can be a great challenge. We must be vigilant against conscious and unconscious bias and prejudice. We do not want to waste the potential contribution of anybody. Tonight, we remember that our nation was built on the premise that each member of our community is to be valued by virtue of their contribution, irrespective of the homeland of their parents or their grandparents. Business accepts our responsibility in upholding these values, to provide leadership, and to offer people the chance to give back. Our history shows us the investment we make in migrants will be repaid tenfold through a lifetime of commitment and contribution, through a commitment that carries forward through many generations. Thank you.